Greetings, Professor Poffenroth, and greetings all classmates. My name is Sorat Pikun-Buntan, and my presentation today will be on marine life on threat. So let us start. The ocean provides a huge source of oxygen for our planet and acts as an instrument to catch and store carbon dioxide. Besides, it is a home to many marine species, from small organisms such as planktons into large ones such as the blue whales. However, due to gas emissions, plastic pollutions, and other human activities, the marine ecosystems and marine life has been severely affected, with many species becoming endangered. After the World War II, demand for food increased rapidly and the ocean has been heavily invaded and exploited. In this presentation, my master's topic will focus on over-harvesting of marine organisms. So what has been happening and what is still happening until this day? Destinations such as the Gulf of California, the Galapagos, the Arctic, and coastal East Africa are the targets of large fishing industries. Today, I have three principles of this ongoing issues. First, we'll be talking about the growing populations that demands for more fish. Second, we will talk about the consequences that we will be receiving and potentially what our future generations are receiving. The third will be the degradations of marine life conditions despite many of government enforcements. So let's take a look at our first discussion. Our first discussion is based on the over-harvesting on marine organisms and the growing populations which demand for the growth of fishing industries. Million tons of fish are collected and run commercially worldwide every year. In each pound of fish that reach the market, 10 to 100 pounds of fish are being thrown away. Think of how much we are wasting fish. What creates a worse problem is that human demands for specific types of fish, which is not only forces the extinction of certain species, but also causes decrease in sustainability in marine biodiversity. This is why humans' demand for specific types of fish creates a much bigger threat than anything in the present day. Because of our endless and careless needs, creating an imbalance in marine ecosystem by overfishing would lead to threatening the consequences for the marine organism themselves and us as consumers. Let us move on to the consequences that we, as the current generations and future generations, are potentially facing. As we all know, many species are currently going into extinction. A scholarly journal titled Comparison of Threat and Exploitation Status in Northeast Atlantic Marine Population lists different species which are threatened by overfishing. Species such as cod, herring, and hake are on the list of extinction probabilities. As we continue to harvest for certain species, we are creating serious imbalances in marine ecosystem. If we harvest faster than cod reproduces and grow, we will face our own consequences of the lack of food sources and possibly the loss of species, which definitely means an extinction to these types of fishes. Why is this issue still continuing? There's a conflict between the act of conserving the marine life and the popular demands from those that are unaware of the threat. And we are causing a serious damage to these poor marine animals. One of the reasons is that there's a lack of effectiveness in rules to protecting the ocean life. Difficulties such as lack of funding to organizations or inadequate arrangements cause a delay in critical conditions that would affect marine species long term. The results from our lack of focus on conserving the ecosystem which marine organisms are part of, we are constantly creating more challenges for the environment and ourselves in the coming generations. As we study the three principles of over-harvesting marine organisms, I would like to present an example, one of the many threatening examples that is happening up until today. Shark finning. Shark finning has been a huge business and is a great demand of shark fins come from countries such as China, Malaysia, and Indonesia. Many believe that consuming sharks is a symbol of high status and is thought to have medicinal benefits. Here is a video by Fusions that explains the cruelty of shark finning.
Is a soup destroying our oceans? Each year, an estimated 100 million sharks are killed for their fins. Shark finning is a brutal practice that involves shearing the fin off the shark. Without fins, sharks can't swim and sink to the ocean floor, becoming food for other fish. The biggest source of demand for these fins? The market for shark fin soup. The soup is considered a delicacy in some cultures and costs up to $200 a bowl. The dish is especially a status symbol in Chinese cuisine dating back to the 14th century. It's also appeared on Malaysian, Indonesian, Spanish, and other countries' menus, and it's long been thought to have medicinal benefits, but doesn't actually. Nutritionally, it's just cartilage that's exceedingly high in toxic mercury. Even though the soup's popularity is shrinking under pressure from protesters and shifts in thinking, the demand for fins is still high. 1 pound of dried shark fin can sell for $300 or more, and it's a multi-billion dollar industry, which means fishing crews are working overtime to harvest the shark fin. And they'll take any shark, regardless of age or size, even though it violates the United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization's Code of Conduct for Responsible Fisheries. Finning is decimating shark populations around the world, causing a 60-90% decrease over the last 15 years. And if finning doesn't stop, experts estimate most shark species will disappear within 10 years. It's a wasteful, cruel practice that is devastating our oceans.
As we cover all the three principles on over-harvesting organism, along with an example of this ongoing issues, what can we do as global citizens of the planet to help conserve and protect marine organisms? It is important that we continue to spread awareness about critical effects that over-harvesting is doing to our planet. We are constantly collecting more than we need without considerations of future consequences. As a generation, we have to gain our understanding on more marine life conditions and what we can do to conserve them. Second, we should continue to educate using many available platforms within our ability. Social media is a great example and a great tool to spread our message across the globe. And lastly, governments should be working closely with scientists and educators in order to well regulate the laws of overfishing. There's need to have a tighter enforcement and a closer control to what is happening on out there in the seas. It is a tough obstacle to go through, but as a collective act, we should urge our governments into preventing as much as we can. This concludes my presentations. Thank you all for listening.